I am your living, breathing example, am I not, of bad posture. I am shocking
my
wife constantly. Yeah, she constantly talks to me. She goes, stand up straight, you're shrinking. Anyway, we all slouch, don't we? At work, at your desk, on your phone, you slouch on the bus, you slouch when you're driving.
I, of course, am the great example of what it is to have great posture, sitting upright, tall. Right now, you may be slouching as you're watching this. And according to one osteopath, bad posture is verging on an epidemic. Tim Wilson went along to straighten himself out.
Everyone knows the office desk is a swamp. Not everyone knows the food court can be a fail. As for devices and the eye hunch, let's face it, no one is safe from bad posture.
Certainly in the last 10 years, it's getting worse. It is almost epidemic, because I see it in almost all people. It doesn't matter what age they are, I'm seeing it with everybody.
Including yours truly.
So if this was the NCEA of posture, have I passed or failed?
You failed. Yeah.
Almost 16% of non-manual workers take time off for physical pain. Your sore backs, necks, knees and the like. The second most common cause of absenteeism from work, often caused by what you do at work. Who are you? It's called Upright Go, a device that fits on your spine, connected to your phone. Every time you slump, the thing vibrates.
Power, oh, there it is.
Isn't working.
It takes a while to boot up, but then success.
It's like being nibbled by a goldfish at the top of your back.
And what a talking point with colleagues.
You got a posture problem?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I think
sports.
Yeah, I don't.
What, sort of a jock like you?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Too much bench press.
Is it? I wouldn't have said that.
How's the family? How's your day? Feel my back.
Yep. Oh. So is it telling you that you're humping? You're slumping.
Not humping. Slumping.
The cure is being more conscious of the way you're sitting and the way you're standing and the way you're driving and the way you're eating.
Because fixing bad posture is not just a matter of bones alone.